Hey, you guys and girls, and thank you for watching another episode of the Xbox Tester. My name is Maurice. Today we are going to play Metro Exodus Enhanced Edition on Xbox Series S. It has a complete overhaul for new gen consoles, and I'm really curious about how it's going to look on the Xbox Series S. I already tried it a little bit on my Series X, and pretty impressive stuff there, but yeah, let's play the Series S version. I think that one is much more impressive than the Series X. Let's get started. First of all, let's see how much data the game is, and that's 67.4 gigabytes. And it's a Scarlet version, so it's fully optimized for the Xbox Series X and S. It should have come out the 18th of this month, but somehow the upgrade for next gen came 2 days earlier. So if you already own Metro Exodus, you can download this upgrade for free. Let's get into it. Oh, and you guys, if you like this kind of content, please don't forget to like and subscribe. It means a lot for me, but it means even more for the channel. You're really helping us out. And you can also follow me on Twitter, by the way. I'm really liking Twitter. So you can find me at the Xbox Tester. Skip, skip, skibbity, skip. Skibbity, bop, bop. So, what's going on with this enhanced edition? By the looks of it, they told us the game will run at 1080p 60fps with ray tracing on. Yeah, from the moment they said that, I was a little bit skeptic and was like, yeah, I don't know if you're going to pull that off. And I was true. It was true. They do have 60fps. No problem. There is most definitely ray tracing going on, but the resolution is not always there. So from maybe some people already saw the video of Digital Foundry. Those guys are much more in depth on resolutions and that kind of stuff than I am. I'm just showing you how a level runs. And they already told us that the 1080p is almost never. Turns out there's still. Yeah, they almost never get to 1080p. It's everywhere between. It's a frame. The frame rate is pretty stable. 60fps, super stable. But the resolution is everywhere between what did they say? Between 512 or something, up to 980p or anything like that.
That will get some answers.
But still, now I hear a lot of people already on my YouTube channel saying, oh, it looks like crap and it's not good and it's a bad. No. No. No, it's definitely not bad, because in graphics it looks amazing. The ray tracing is insane. The 60fps is insane, and you guys keep in mind, this is a $299 next gen console. So, mind blown.
And now I'm looking at this fog. Thinking it could actually be hiding.
This shouldn't be even. This shouldn't be possible.
We should be approaching the bridge soon.
So I get a lot of people saying that you kind of see the ray tracing in the water. That's the only thing you can't see on both on all the console versions. There are no ray tracing water reflections. Not on Series S, X, or PS5. Not a single one has that option. So it's the ray tracing is much more how light works on 3D stuff like your weapon, as you can see right now on your weapon, how the light of the sun reacts to your weapon. That's much more what this ray tracing does. And the shadows, a lot more shadow stuff.
Damn fog! Seems we ran through someone's roadblock.
And to be honest, I think this game looks insane. Of course, I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. I'm not gonna say, "Oh my God, it's the best thing ever." No, I'm playing this on a 32-inch 1440p gaming monitor, and yes, I can see the pixels. Most definitely. If I watch here behind, I can see the pixels in the shadows. And even the resolution on the faces is not that really high. See this guy. You can definitely see it. But is that a big problem? No. Because after 5 minutes of playing this game, you will be completely into the game. Because it looks so natural now.
Let's go, Artyom.
Spartans, let's prepare the Aurora for a defensive action.
This is pretty insane. How the light works. You can see the light reflecting. It's insane.
It doesn't come with crafting materials though, so keep an eye out for those.
Let's move on.
This is Series S, you guys.
Be careful out there.
Sure thing. I gotta say.
But yeah, can you see pixels or that kind of stuff? Yeah, sure. You can, if you were watching the in the distance.
Be careful out there. Remember,
there's even, I saw already in some parts of the game, there's a little bit of pop-up even. Here and there. But, yeah, a few things that are pretty amazing. I will going to show you that one too. But this is all good. One thing that's unique for the Xbox Series S and X, that it has a native spatial audio Dolby Atmos. So this game is fully Dolby Atmos optimized for Xbox Series S and X, not on PlayStation 5. So if you want to play this game with true Dolby Atmos, can only be done on play on Xbox Series S and X. You've got a field of view. If you like that, you've got this is a cool one because you got a lot of different kind of motion blurs, and I put it on low. I can put it off. Normally, I'm not that into motion blur. Let's get it off. I don't think it even needs motion blur that much. And if you guys think I sound a little bit strange, I've got a little bit of a cold right now. So I'm sounding probably a little bit nasal. It's insane how the light reacts to this world. I think this one was cool to see with the light post. How these shadows react. And you get shadows from the stones. That needs so much power. Looks insane. So if you have a gaming monitor with a VRR, for instance, you won't even see that much difference in the resolutions. I have a lot of difficulties seeing the skips in resolution. And I don't even use VRR right now because my recording software doesn't like it when I use VRR. Look at this. This is insane.
Our father, Silanthius, has already started his sermon.
Get inside.
Enter the temple and see the light.
Lights or the fire. How that reacts. This is pretty good. Where the light comes from. This is dark. Where it needs to be dark, it's dark. Where it needs to be light, light. That's pretty insane. I really love the looks of it. And this is on a Series S, you guys, still. This is on a Series S.
Mama, it's him! The man from the train! He's here to save us!
I can't believe this. I had all but lost hope. We're not from here either. Silanthius locked us up here a year ago. Yes, the bridge dwellers.
And I even think this is one of the first.
But I'll tell you everything I've seen in this place.
Triple A games.
Oh, it's the bridge guard.
Here you can see it very good.
Just like the locals, but unlike them, the bridge guard.
Oh, it reacts.
Run! There's a way out down here, and there's a boat at the dock.
We also have.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
It's too small for all of us.
Artyom, she's right. Get to the boat. We will rescue her later. Don't worry.
Go.
These are some insane graphics on the Series S. Knockout! Stay down. Now what? Wow, this whole complete city is underwater. Pretty insane.
I'm no saint like Father Silanthius to take it all like he does.
And this looks beautiful. If you're playing this on a yeah, this looks a little bit pixelated. If you look at that fire, I'm getting closer. Yeah, this is definitely pixelated. But look how the Fire is reacting on the walls. With an orange glow. But yeah, the fire is one of the things that doesn't look that good in the game. No, fires are the Series S really hates fire. But yeah, let's make it rain a little bit.
Brothers, the heathens are...
I think it looks stunning. Pretty insane what they did with the Series S version. The game. I don't even know what to do right now. This is insane how it looks. Bye bye. Bye bye, buddy.
I have had it with fights. I give up. Give up.
But yeah, I think this is a pretty good look at Metro Exodus running on Xbox Series S. And yeah, I think personally. I think it looks better than I expected. The only thing I really have something to say about is the... Ah, fuck you. Die. I'm an evil man. But, yeah. Thanks for watching to this episode of the Xbox Tester. And till next time. Bye-bye.